come here and give you the gup. Jaise you know, doodh phat jata hai na, bald patch of my skin. Back to my channel. Welcome back to another video. For today's video, I am putting two very famous overhyped foundations and concealers to the test, and I'm gonna battle these two against each other. I have the Huda Beauty 4 Filter Stick Foundation as well as the Overachiever Concealer on one side of my face. On the other side of my face, I have the Maybelline Superstay Foundation with the Age Rewind Concealer. This is like a drugstore versus high-end complexion battle. Let's see which performs better against the other. I have used some of these products before, and some of these are going to be first impressions. All of this I recently shopped on Nykaa and shared with y'all in my haul video, and y'all wanted to see like a complete trying new makeup thing. So I thought I would put both of these to the test and actually see how it wears, how it performs with all of my other tried and trusted makeup. And also I'm going to wear this makeup for the next 4 to 5 hours. There will be a proper wear test to see how this makeup wears outdoors throughout the evening. So if you're interested, then continue watching. But if this is the first time you've come onto my channel, then hi, I'm Sara. I make beauty and lifestyle content here on YouTube. If this is the first time you've come here, then take a moment, hit that subscribe button, join the Sara squad. I'm sure you'll love it here. And also don't forget to hit the bell icon right next to it so that every time I upload a video, you get notified. And with that, we can dive straight into this. Without wasting any time whatsoever, I'm directly going to dive in with the two foundations which are going to be the talk of the town today. I have applied moisturizer, prepped my skin really well. Of course, before I go into this, I'm going to use the new primer as well that I did shop on Nykaa when I did this entire haul. So this is by Maybelline. This is their Fit Me Matte Plus Poreless Primer. I've only used this once before and I did have a very good experience. It didn't irritate my skin whatsoever. I like the consistency. It's creamy, but at the same time, once you apply it, it fills and blurs your pores really well. I have taken quite a lot of primer. I didn't need to, but you can see what a matte finish it gives. It doesn't apply dewy at all. Doesn't give any shine whatsoever to my skin. Just on the high points of my face, I'm going to use a little bit of the MAC Strobe Cream so that the hydration factor is also there. The dewy look is also there. On Diwali, I don't want to look like completely matte and caked up. The skin is well prepped. Now diving straight into the foundations. First, on this side, I'm going to use the Huda Beauty Stick Foundation. This is their 4 Filter Stick Foundation. I have the shade Toffee, and this is a foundation I have used before. By now, I think 5 times I have worn this foundation. I will tell you what I feel about it. Like you can see, it's pretty full coverage. Huda Beauty products are very, very full coverage that I like. The first time I wore it, I somehow felt like it was sitting on my skin and it didn't blend very well, but giving it the benefit of the doubt, I did apply it when I was in the car. I was rushing for the Bandra shoot with Heliwith, and that is when I did my makeup in the car and I applied this. So one advantage of a stick foundation is always that you can do your makeup on the go. For this side, I'm going to use the Henna Henna Beauty sponge and I'm going to dab this foundation. You can see how much product I've taken. After applying so much product also, I feel like the coverage is not full instantly. The sponge ends up taking a lot of the product. Again, pressing some more foundation into my skin, I'm building up the coverage because I want full coverage makeup as always. Now that I have the Huda Beauty foundation applied, you can see how the finish looks. It is full coverage, but a lot of my imperfections do seep through on my face. It's very, very close to my skin tones. The shade Toffee suits me perfectly. This foundation does not oxidize at all. I have worn it before. I feel like if you compare the Huda Beauty stick foundation to the Huda Beauty liquid foundation, definitely the stick foundation is a winner for me because this coverage is very full, but at the same time the feel is very skin like. This foundation really feels like paint on my skin. It feels very, very heavy, but the coverage of this one is much, much, much more full coverage as opposed to the 4 Filter stick foundation. This is literally like it can camouflage your tattoos and everything. This is more like an on the go, swipe it, apply it, it's quick to blend and all of that. Looks very good on the skin, I will not deny that. Next, I'm gonna go on this side with the Maybelline Superstay foundation. Now this foundation I have never used at all. I wanted to use one foundation and one concealer from the opposite sides before, so I'm not giving you like a complete first impressions over here. Some of this is like a review, some is first impression. I have the shade 312 Golden. I'm gonna give you a first impressions. The consistency is quite good. I've pumped 2 drops of the foundation for 1/2 of my face. I believe it's gonna be slightly lighter for me. But a lot of y'all told me that this foundation does oxidize, so I think it will match my skin tone after that. I've not completely used up the 2 pumps. On this side, I'm going to use the Plume and Co. makeup sponge and I'm going to dab this foundation on this side of my face. Instantly, I feel like the coverage on the Maybelline Superstay is much higher as opposed to the 4 Filter coverage. Let me see how much does this foundation oxidize, because this side is clearly lighter than this side right now. Okay, I really like the coverage on the Maybelline Superstay. It's banging full coverage, dude. It's much more full coverage than the Maybelline Fit Me also. And it's matte, huh? It's like completely setting matte instantly. I feel like this is the kind of foundation you want to blend fast, because if you don't blend quickly, then it might set in place. Just looking at my skin right now in the mirror, I feel like I like my skin more on this side. Just because this is more full coverage doesn't mean that this is feeling more cakey. In fact, I've used very less product because one complete pump is still on my hand, and this is just like half a pump on this side of my face, and I've swiped so much of the Pore Filter foundation on this side. This is more skin-like. This definitely looks like foundation, but for something like a Diwali dinner right now, I would prefer this sort of coverage, this sort of finish. I don't know how both of them will wear throughout the day. I am going to wear this makeup for a good 4 to 5 hours now for my dinner. So I want to see how they both wear. But I think this color also corrects quite a lot. And you can see this oxidizing and now slowly, slowly matching up to the Pore Filter. Now let's do the concealer bit. So for this side, I'm going to use the Maybelline Age Rewind Concealer. Like you can see, I've used a little bit of this product because I wanted to give this more of a review. Whereas the Overachiever Concealer, I have never used. This is going to be of first impressions. Diving first in the Huda Beauty side, this is their high coverage creamy concealer, and I have the shade Caramel Corn. In this, you end up getting like 10 ml of product for about 2520. It has this cooling tip, which I like because instantly it feels very, very cooling on my skin. Okay, so I've taken a fair amount of product on this side with the Huda Beauty Overachiever Concealer. I'm going to let this sit a little bit. I'm going to go in with the Maybelline Age Rewind. This has a different applicator, the sponge-like thing. I don't prefer this applicator that much. I feel like the sponge is going to break off anytime because I apply a lot of pressure. So this I have in the shade Caramel again. Okay, Henna Henna Beauty Sponge going on the Huda Beauty side. Oh my god, the Huda Beauty Overachiever is full coverage and how? Really like that. What I usually use, utna hi maine use kiya hai. Aisa kuch overboard ja ke maine zyada product nahi use kiya. But wow, look at that coverage on the Huda Beauty Overachiever Concealer. And Caramel Corn is slightly light for me, but I believe after powder and everything, it should look fine. Now I think by both sides are going to look very, very different. First impressions, I'm totally a fan of how this looks on my skin. My under eyes look so bright, so awake, and I love the color also. It has just color corrected all my darkness. It made the entire side look so bright and so even complexion. Like even though the Pore Filter foundation gave us more of a natural finish, it didn't give us a very full coverage finish despite using so much product. But the Overachiever Concealer, I feel like, has done a very, very good job. And also, it's not creasing immediately. Even though I'm speaking so much, it's not creasing on my laugh lines or anything. The creasing bit will be put to test a little more ahead of the day. I'm gonna blend with this sponge on this side of my face, on the Maybelline side of my face. As for the Age Rewind Concealer, I have really been enjoying it. I've been using it non-stop ever since I got it. And I feel like the blending again is super quick, super easy. Just like the Huda Beauty one, barely took me any effort to blend into my skin. And it looks very, very skin-like and also does not crease at all, because I've worn it so many times before for long shoot days. And this concealer has not creased on me. So I think it's a great find again to have in your makeup kit. The shade Caramel does not highlight the way the Caramel Corn from the Huda Beauty did. It's a concealer shade very, very close to my skin tone, but I like that. Like for a daily sort of a wear, this concealer is great. And for more of a poof, like a wedding or a Diwali dinner sort of a makeup, I think this concealer brightens a lot more. I think after a good amount of oxidization of the Maybelline Superstay foundation, and now that the concealers are also well set into my skin, both of the sides look pretty even when it comes to the skin tone. As for the finish, these under eyes look much brighter. Both are not creasing. This looks more like subdued. Of course, it has color corrected on both sides, but this definitely looks a lot brighter. If I'm gonna apply eyeshadow and everything, this side of my face I think will pop a lot more. I'll give you like a quick zoom in as to how my skin is looking right now. The closer I look, both of these concealers are creasing only on that first problematic under eye line that I have. But apart from that, it's not that bad a creasing on the rest of my face. I like the foundation finish on the Maybelline Superstay. So far, so good. This looks so well concealed, so well filtered, sort of. And I use so little product for this. That is what I love the most. Because this side, itna sara product vapra, but phir bhi you can see these imperfections just peeking through. And I do not mind the imperfections, but I feel like for that kind of money, I want like full coverage. The stick foundation is like an on-the-go thing. Of course, the liquid foundation is a little difficult to travel with. Let me know in the comments, what do you think about the finishes, the skin tone and everything. I'm gonna do the rest of my makeup and be right back. Okay, so the weirdest thing happened now. You know how I do my full face of makeup and after that I just spritz my face with like the makeup fixing spray. I know I look a little weird. I don't have lashes or any eye makeup on right now. But once I sprayed my MAC Fix Plus on my face, this is like my tried and trusted, and all of the other products I've used on my face today are all my tried, tested and products I already love. And then I picked up all the excess product with a sponge and this side completely separated. The concealer completely separated, it like just split, just as you know, dood fat jata na, vaise it completely split. I don't know if you can tell because now I've like of course fixed it. I want to go out wearing this face of makeup. But this side, a little bit, the concealer might look patchy to you. Over here, definitely, you can see like a little bit of the area does not have concealer. And that's because when I was picking up excess product, all of the concealer actually came onto the sponge. And that's very weird because the Maybelline side did not do that. And none of my concealers or my products ever do that with me. They don't separate when you put makeup fixing spray. The makeup fixing spray is actually supposed to help it fix better. Now, I don't know if the MAC Fix Plus did not go well with the Huda Beauty concealer. But this was something so uncalled for, and I was so much leaning towards the Huda Beauty concealer because I was really liking the finish of it till I did my entire makeup, and then the MAC Fix Plus just was the changing game to the equation. I'm gonna apply my mascara, my lenses and all of that. I'll be right back, but I just had to come here and give you the gup. Alrighty guys, so this is what the full face of makeup looks. This is the Huda Beauty side, this is the Maybelline side. I am inching slightly towards the Maybelline side. I do have my claims for why I like the finish of the foundation. I already told you all that the concealer sits very natural, the foundation is super full coverage. As opposed to the Huda Beauty one, the Huda Beauty's foundation is more sheer coverage and the concealer definitely was a complete put off for me when it separated after applying setting spray. But I'm still gonna give both of the complexion products a fair shot of like 3-4 hours. It's 7:30 right now in the evening. I'm gonna wear this makeup I think till 11-12 o'clock at night, and once I'm done I will give you like a check-in and let's see what our thoughts are and do our thoughts change after wearing this makeup outdoors and in the humidity and everything.
6.5 hours later.
Alrighty guys, this foundation test has stood the test of time. It is 1:45 right now. Main itni thak gayi hu, the Diwali party went quite long and proper 6.5 actually 6 hours 45 minutes that I've been wearing this makeup. We went for a drive, we went all the way to town, we had a very adventurous Diwali to say the least. Not all of it was happy. My car took quite a lot of damage today. Let's not get into the details of that. Let's talk about the face of makeup we have right here. So my lipstick did go through a lot of touch-ups, but and my outfit is also changed because the previous outfit was not working out. So I had changed kar liya tha nikalne se pehle. But the foundation has completely rubbed off from my forehead, if you can tell. Like there is no foundation on both the sides of my forehead, but more so on this side, to bilkul bhi foundation concealer is literally there's a bald patch of my skin. Whereas on this side, still it's like an even fade. Same goes for the nose. The nose doesn't have foundation on both sides. This side of my face just I feel looks a lot fresher. It looks something that is durable. 6.5 hours later, both of my foundations have faded their coverage quite a lot. It's not like both are now full coverage even right now. Both of them have sheared out, but since this was already more of a natural finish, this has faded even more, whereas this still looks like very, very fresh side of my face. Like that's how I feel. Now let me know in the comments, what do you think? Let me give you like a quick close-up. This is what it looks like up close. Of course, I'm very tired. My face also looks very tired. But I feel like the under eyes, both sides are very fresh even now. Both the concealers have actually not creased at all. I'm very impressed with the Huda concealer under the eyes actually, because it's not only not creased, it's also very matte and very much there, whereas the Maybelline concealer is also there, but it's slightly sheared down on coverage, I would say. In my honest opinion, I definitely think Maybelline wins the award today. I think for a price of about 400, 500 for the concealer and 700 for the foundation, a rough roundabout of like 1300 on this side of my face and a rough roundabout of like 6,000-7,000 on this side of my face, I definitely believe like the 1300 is worth an investment, both for going out for long wear makeup days and also for like a short everyday visit, because it's not breaking your bank, plus looks so flawless and so good in coverage. Definitely think that the Huda concealer is something you can try, although it did separate, but apart from that, everything else did check the list: the coverage, the finish, the blendability, the brightness, the color correction, also the color diversity. But you're getting very less product, just 10 ml for about 2520. So make your call with that. I think the stick foundation is definitely like a pass. I have it, so I will use it. It's not something extraordinaire where I will feel like, you know, you have to have this. This is like a must have. It's definitely like a go-to, easy and quick to use. But I feel like the sugar stick foundation, which is like $800, performs just as good as this one. I can do like a compare reel on the two of the foundations. Let me know if that is something that interests you. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. For today's video, Sarah Sport shoutout goes to Nish Shah. Thank you so much for watching and supporting my channel. If you want to be a part of next video, Sarah Sport shoutout, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button, bell icon, like next video, and also leave a comment down below saying hashtag Sarah Sport. And if you get a chance to be a part of my next video, Sarah Sport shoutout. I will see you guys very soon in another video. Bye guys, love you.